Hello friends, I am Naishik from blogdude.com and welcome to another amazing video. Now today in this video, I'll introduce you to an awesome and free form building plugin which is Happy Forms. Now this is a really cool plugin and it has a tons of features. First of all, it's a drag and drop form builder, so you don't need to know any coding, any HTML, CSS and so on. Another feature is that you can see a live preview of your form that you're creating. So you don't need to click on that save button, go to that page, refresh it to see the changes. You can see the changes live on your screen, okay, in real time. You can also easily add forms anywhere you want on your pages, post. You also get a widget with this plugin. So you can use your forms on your sidebar, in your footer or wherever you want. You also get those shortcodes so that it makes it very easy for you to insert your forms anywhere you want. You can also add multiple forms to one single page. It's all up to you. Now this is completely mobile responsive, tablet responsive. So this is a great thing. Okay, this is really important in today's time when mobile browsing is given very much importance by Google. Okay, so very important. Now another feature is that you get a confirmation mail. Now there are many plugins that do have all these features, like they are drag and drop, live preview. But the problem with them is that whenever you send some mail, or whenever the person receives the mail, or you receive the mail that someone has submitted a form, something like that, a contact or form maybe, then what happens is the message you receive is in spam box. Now that is a problem. So in this plugin, that is not the problem, at least what I have seen till now. So for me, that is not a problem here. So that is a great thing over here. Now another feature is that you can redirect to any web page that you want after the form is submitted. So suppose you're giving some free layouts or something free. So what happens is the person is submitting the form. Once the form is submitted, you can redirect them to that download free layout pages and so on, or you can redirect them to a thank you page or so on. Okay, so it's all up to you. This is also a great feature, I think. Another feature is that you can you get one click honeypot and Google reCAPTCHA spam prevention. So you will get that reCAPTCHA thing when you have to click on that reCAPTCHA. Sometimes it gives you some images to do so and all those things, or some calculation and so on. So Google reCAPTCHA can also be integrated with this form. There are many more features that are included in this plugin, but what we'll do is we'll directly go to the page, see how we can create a form, and you will understand it much better. And by the way, with this plugin you can create almost any kind of forms, like ranging from simple contact form, feedback forms, registration forms, get a quote form, then book a service form and so on. Now if you see over here, I have already created a form, book a service form. You can see and you'll get a better idea how it looks and how you can create your own form. So if you see over here at the top, we have our title, then we have two different inputs over here, first name, last name, then we have a phone number field, then we have single selection options like what kind of service are you making. Now this is basically I have put in my mind as maybe a car or vehicle repairing shop or so on. Okay, so what kind of service do you want? Routine service, previous repair or warranty service, when would you like to have your car repaired? So you can select the date, and any comments for the mechanic, they can put in their comment and they can submit the form. So you can create any kind of form. As I said, there are many different inputs that we can use. There are many different fields like date, label, then we have multi-select, single select, then we also have a legal thing and so on. You can also integrate CAPTCHA, as I have said you. So let's see how we can create forms. I'll be creating two different forms in this video. The first one will be a simple contact us form, and the second one will be the form which you see on your screen, that is book a service form. Okay, so with that being said, let's get started. Now the first thing that you have to do, you have to install the plugin if you have not already done that. So that's really easy. You know how to do that. You go to your dashboard. If you don't know how to go to your dashboard, just type in your domain name /wp-admin. Okay, so when you type that, you'll be redirected to your dashboard. Now at the left hand side, we have this plugins, hover plugins, and click on add new. Now here you can search for Happy Forms. Let's search for Happy Forms. Let's see what comes. So this is the plugin by the Theme Foundry. You can see at present it has around 600 plus active installs. It has got 5-star rating by 6 people, and it is updated 2 weeks ago. So quite a good plugin, At present, because I have already installed and activated it, I'm not getting any button like this. But if you have not already done that, you'll see a button something like this, install now, and after that you have to activate the plugin. Once you activate the plugin, you'll see a new option over here, just like what I see, Happy Forms. Let's click on this. Now as you can see, I have already created two forms over here, Booker Service and Contact Us form. Okay, now you'll get this thing already, sample contact form, but this is not very important. What I'll do is I'll create a new form from scratch just to show you guys how you can do it. Okay, so let's see how we can do that. First, we have to click on this add new button. Alright, so this is the screen that you'll get when you click on that add new button. Here we have some options. Here we have all the fields that you can use, all the options that you can use. At the extreme right side, you'll see the live preview of your form. Okay, so the first thing that we have to do, we have to give a name to this form. Then this name will appear over here, and we can obviously style the form. It's all up to you. You can style it anywhere or however you want. Okay, and if you want, you can just disable the title. If you don't want to show the title, you can just delete it from your, that title will disappear. Or if you want, you can give us title like contact us or something like that. Okay, so it's all up to you. Okay, so we have our title. The next thing that we have to do, we have to drag all these parts, whatever part you want, we have to drag and drop over here. Or what you can do, you can simply click on this. There are many different fields. You can see short name, long name, email, web link, and all those, address, scale, title, legal, and so on. So what I'm doing is I'm creating a simple contact us form. So I'll need a short text first. So let's click on this. So as you can see, when you click on this one, you get these new options over here, and you can see in your live preview, we have this thing, this field over here. So the first field that I want is first name. So I'll type in first name over here. And you can see the changes over here. Okay, so the title will come at the top. Okay, when, like we see in most of the contact forms. So we have the first name. Then you can also, we also have the option for title placement. By default, it is at top. You can place it at left. So, or there are many more options, like you can also place it below or inside the input. So inside this input, we can also place this. You can also display this as a placeholder. So this is the coolest option that I like. Displaying it as a placeholder is the great option, or you can also place it inside input. Okay, so it all depends on what kind, how do you want to design it. Okay, suppose if you want only one field per line, what you can do, you can select the left one. That will also look very cool. Then you can have last name and all those things. Then if you're planning something else, it's all up to you. So what I'm doing over here is I'm selecting inside input. Okay, this will look very beautiful after we complete the form and design it. Okay, just see. Then after that, you can also give some description, like let us type something like enter your first name here. Okay, so you can see the description at the bottom. Again, spelling mistake. Okay, no, not a problem. So we have the description showing up over here. Now there is another option, I think, which is a very cool option. Again, you can show this description in a tooltip just by tick marking this option. Now as you can see, when you tick mark this option, we have this tooltip over here, question mark. When someone hovers over this, you can see it says enter your first name over here. Okay, so very cool option, really nice option. You can also have a placeholder. So instead of placeholder, instead of some name, I can just type in John, so that people know what they have to type over here. Then if you see over here, you can make it required. If you want to make this field required, by default it is tick mark, which is it is marked at required. But if you want, you can just untick this, and this field will no more be required. Okay, so the user can skip this field and still their form will get submitted. And if you tick mark this, the user, if the user leaves this field empty and try to submit the form, they will get an error which says, you know, please fill all the required fields and so on. Okay, now if you see over here, you can delete this, you can duplicate it, you can just click on done. If you are done with this, then is another option which says advanced. When you click on this, you can change the width of this one. For example, instead of full, you can make it half. Now this is what we want to do, because what we are planning is we'll have first name, then we'll have last name over here. Okay, so let's duplicate this one. Why? Because we don't want to do, if you select this short text again, we'll have to do everything again, like, you know, putting the text, changing the placement and all those things. So what we can do, we can simply delete this and we can duplicate this one. Okay, now as you can see, most of the settings are already done because of the duplication, so you don't have to do a lot. Now let's change everything. Now instead of this, let's name it last name, and instead of enter your first name, let's type in enter your last name here, so when someone hovers over here they can see it. And instead of this placeholder, let's type in Doe, John Doe. Okay, so we have two fields over here. You can see it's really, really easy. Now after this, I want maybe the phone number field. Now obviously you can have the short text, you can have the same text, and you can just type in phone over here. Let me show you phone or phone number, and this will do. But what we do, it basically, this is not the professional way of doing it, this is the wrong way. Okay, so you can do it like this also. People can come and type in their phone number, that will do, but we don't do it like this. We can delete this because we already have a field specifically for phone number. So we have this thing over here. For a number there is a different field, and for phone number there is a different field. So we'll select phone number over here. So let's type in phone number as the title. Okay, and again we'll select the same thing. Now okay, let's select it inside. Okay, we have the phone number here. You can tick mark over here to apply to all parts. Okay, and let's type in enter your phone number here. Obviously that is not required, I'm just showing you, you can do this and you have these options as well. Okay, and instead of this you can have some placeholder just to show how a demo thing will look like. Okay, just the person should know what they have to put over here. So I have put some demo number over here. Fine, so we have the phone number, and after that you can add some more field, but basically in a contact us form, simple contact us form, you don't have too many fields. You have simple name, email address and message, that's it. Or name, phone number, message, that's it. So if you want, you insert a phone number, you can have that email option as well. Now at the bottom, I want to have this message or long text thing. Okay, so instead of text, I'll type in message over here. All right, now again, I'll put it inside. Now most of the time, in fact all the time, you should always see that whatever you're selecting for one, select the same style for other. For example, for, don't do it like this, like for one field the title is placed outside, for another field it is placed inside, for another field it is placed above, and so on. Don't do it like this. If you're placing the title inside for one, place it for all, that will look much better. Now as you can see, this is already started looking so good. Okay, so let's type in the description as, please type in your message over here. Okay, so you can see the description over here. All right, let me copy it from here. Let us display this as a tooltip, and let's put this the same thing as the placeholder. Okay, so we have a simple and a beautiful contact us form ready with us. Now we don't have to do much thing, just click on this next step, because we are done with the first step, which is, you know, giving a name and building the form. We are done with the next first step, so let's click on next. Now when you click on next, you will see some more options. The first one is very, very important. You have to put in your email address where you want to receive all the confirmation. Now whenever someone fills in this form and submits it, what is the email address that you want to receive all these submitted forms? So you can enter that email address over here. And by the way, you can also see these messages on your WordPress dashboard. I'll show you where you can see that. Okay, now message alert. Whenever someone clicks on this submit form and submits the form, what should be the message alert? So you can have your message alert over here. Your message has been successfully sent. We appreciate you contacting us and we'll be in touch soon. So you can change this message if you want. If you want, for example, I want the same text, but I just want to add my name at the end. So I can do that. Then after that, we have confirmation email subject. Okay, let me, okay, your message has been successfully sent. You know, again, you can change it. It's all up to you. and here you have to put in the redirect link. Now we'll see this in the next example, okay? Then we have submit button text. Here the submit button says submit form. If you want to delete it, if you want to change it, it's all up to you. I want this button to say only submit, okay? So I can do this as well. Now make sure this thing is tick mark spam prevention, and also tick mark this thing save messages for this form so that you can see the messages on your dashboard as well. Now again, Google reCAPTCHA I'll show you in the next example, okay? So once you do the second step, again click on next. Now this is the final step. Here we will design the form, okay? So first is the general option. When you click on this, you can set a width to this form. For example, this is full width. We can change this. Let's see what happens when you change this. Now you can see when I have put 50%, we can see this form only in 50%. Now this is also a very good thing. If you want, you can set this to say 70-80%. I think 80% is looking good. Now if you're creating a form in some other language like Urdu or Arabic, you can select this right to left thing as well, RTL, okay? So this is applied for this one as well, but we are creating this in English, so we'll select the normal LTR, that is left right, and required text, whatever thing is required, what do you want there. So we have one single asterisk sign over here. If you want to put three asterisks, you can put it over here, okay? It will display over here. So whatever is required, it will display three asterisks. Now you can select the font width, bold or normal, and few colors over here. When the form is successfully submitted, what is the color that you want to show? So basically it is the green color, so I think everything is fine over here. So once you're done with this, click on this back button. So we are done with the general options. Let's see the form title. You can also change few things over here. If you want, you can simply hide the form title, or if you want to show it, if you want to change the alignment, you can make it center align. You can change the font of this thing, font size. Let us see. I think we have to increase it from here. All right. So you can do it from here. It's all up to you. So again, let me delete it from here. Fine. Okay, fine. So let us put 60. Now, as you can see, the changes over here. If you want 40, you can see the changes over here again. So I want 60, some big font size. Maybe 60 is looking quite big. So let's put 50. This is looking perfect. Now again, let's click on this back button. Now third one is a very important option. This is the main styling option, part borders and spacing. So let's click on this. So what do you want? Do you want to show the border? If you see over here, in all the fields, we have this gray color thin border. So if you want, you can have this, or you can simply hide this. Now obviously this is not at all looking like a form. So what I will recommend you is, if you want to hide this, you can do so, but you have to do some changes. Let me show you what changes, okay? So first is that border radius. So because we don't have the border, you cannot see what this radius is. So let me show this, and after that we can see. If you select the square, you'll see all the fields are very simple square or rectangle shape. If you select this round, you'll see the corners of this field get rounded. You can see it, okay? If you see it carefully, or when you try it by yourself, you can see it, okay? If you want, you can select this pill. Now you can see it is kind of a circular thing, okay? So this is also looking good, but I want the round. I think round one is looking better. So you can select the outer padding. If you want, you can select wide. Now as you can see, there is a lot of difference and gap between all the fields. If you want, you can select narrow. Now if you see, there is very thin gap between all the fields. Or if you want, you can select the default one. Now inner padding can also be adjusted. Again, as you can see, narrow, default and wide. Now here we have the color option. So I don't want the border, so I'll hide it from here. Now border on focus. Now this is important. Whenever it says on focus, it means when someone clicks on this. Okay, for example, when someone clicks on this, what should be the border color? So for example, I would say red color. So let's see what happens. Okay, maybe we cannot see the changes over here, but when I do this, when I use this form, you will see those changes. Okay, so our border on radius. Okay, fine. I think just because we have set this to hide. Now let's see, let's show this. Now as you can see, when I select any one of this, for example, when I select this message, you can see the border has turned red. Okay, so it says, okay, you are on this thing. Okay, so this is also quite important, I think. All right, so we have background color. If you want, you can change the background color. I want to do this. So I want to change the background color to something like this, I guess. Okay, let's see. Very light gray color. I think E8. You can see the color code over here. If you see, this is the color code. Hashtag E8. You can, if you want the same color, you can use this. Okay. Now background on focus. Whenever you are selecting this thing, what should be the background? So maybe I want some darker color over here. Whenever some field is selected or on focus, I want a darker background color, a little bit darker like this, or maybe a more darker. Okay, so you can select this as well. If you want, you can change the color completely. Okay, like this. Okay, and you can, if you think this red is very dark, you can make it a little bit lighter by adjusting it from here. Now as you can see, it is quite lighter. If you want, you can make it more lighter like this. You can select different color. Okay, you'll see the changes over here. Let's make it light. Okay, so you have these options. You can play around with these options to see how your form looks. Okay, so this is a very cool thing, which is a very cool option, I guess. Now let's come back and let's see part labels and text. Okay, so you can adjust all this text over here. First of all, do you want to show the titles, which is this one, first name, last name and all this thing? If you want, you can simply hide it. Now as you can see, everything is gone, but if you want to show this. Now text alignment, you can make it center, right, you can see the changes over here, but I want left. You can also change the font size if you can make it normal, bold, it's all up to you. Some basic options over here. The main important options are these color options. Okay, so title color, value color, then placeholder color. For example, if you see this dark gray color is the placeholder, if you want to change the placeholder color, make it red. You can see now all the placeholder are red. Okay, so you can do this color changes as well. Okay, but I want to make it something like this dark gray, which is fine. Now required text, as you can see, this asterisk color, by default it is to orange. You can change that color as well. Now rating, we have not used it, the rating, but you have rating color. If you want, you can change the rating color as well. So these are some more color options. Okay, now again let's come back, and the last option is submit button. Okay, we can make some changes in on this submit button as well. If you want, we can simply hide it, hide the border, but I don't want to do that. I just want this simple button, but I just want to make it full width. Now as you can see, when I submit, select full width, this is how the button becomes. Okay, so I think this is looking better in my opinion. If you think the default look looks better, you can select the default. I think this is looking better. Now you can select these colors as well. You can select the background color, background hover color, and so on. So you get the thing. Okay, you get the idea how you make changes to this design. Now once you are done, you simply click on save form, and if you see over here, let's see where it is. This is the one that we have just created, contact us. Now besides this, you'll see this shortcode. You can simply click on this link, copy to clipboard, and this shortcode will be copied. Now we can use this shortcode to place our form anywhere we want. For example, let me create a new page. So let's hover our pages and click on add new. Let's give it a title of contact us. Okay, let's click on publish. Now let me do few things, few changes over here. First of all, I want full width, and okay, I think this is the only change I want. So let's click on update. And by the way, this is the OceanWP theme, which is a free theme, an awesome theme. I'll soon do a review on this theme, which is really, really good theme. It's free. The best thing, it's free, and you have a lot of customization options. For example, as you can see, I just did it full width, simply use selecting this option. Okay. So more about this theme in later videos. Okay, not in this video. Let's open this page in a new tab. So we have a simple blank page. Now let's paste the shortcode over here. Okay, so we have the shortcode. Let's update this page. Let's refresh this page now. Okay, now as you can see, simply by pasting that short code, we have our contact, beautiful contact form over here. We can select this thing, you can see all the changes. Let's submit a simple form. Let's click on submit. Okay, now as you can see, this green color, your message has been successfully sent and all this blah blah blue. So let's refresh this page. Now if you don't want to copy this short code, let's delete this. You also have this option, add happy forms. You can select this, you can select the form that you want to add, for example this contact us, click on insert, and you'll have this same short code over here. So you can do either way, it's all up to you. Alright guys, so we have seen how to create this form. Now let's do some changes in this form and let's add some more options to make it a more different kind of form, a more complicated form. Okay, so let's again click on happy forms. Let's select the contact us form that we have just selected and let's make it something like this. Okay, book a service. So we have the first name, last name, we have the phone number. Let's add these two options. What kind of service are you making, are you wanting, and so on. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll select this one, single option. Where is that gone? Here it is, single choice. Select this thing. All right now what we'll do is we'll type in, what kind of service do you want, or whatever you want. Okay, it's all up to you, it's your form. Okay, so I want this to be placed, let's see what. Okay, so we have something like this over here. Okay, here the style is totally different. If you see, everything is placed above, so I'll have to place it above just like it is. Okay, and do we have any description? No, we don't have any description. First let me do one thing, let me select everything. Let's select the first one, let's make it above just to match the same style. Okay, then select the last name, make it above just like this. Then we have the phone number above. Okay, so we, and then we message, and obviously we'll do some changes in the message. Then after that we have what kind of service you want, and after, if you see, we have almost the same options. Okay, we can just add these options. So if you want to add an option, you can click on this link, add option. Now the first option over here is routine service. So let's type in routine service. All right, so we have this option. Now after that, if you want to add a more option, you can simply click on add option. Now let's add previous repair. Okay, so let's add previous repair. And let's add one more option, click on add option, and let's add warranty, simply warranty. Okay, now if you see over here, this style is different. Here we have the horizontal, you can have a horizontal, vertical style, both the options are available. Let me show you. Okay, let's click on this advanced. When you click on this advanced, you have this vertical or horizontal, so I want to select horizontal. Okay, now we have exactly like the demo website, and obviously the design is a bit different because we have changed the design. Now after this we have, when would you like your vehicle repaired, and after that we have some date options. So let's add this one. So select this one, date and time, and let's change the title. Where is that? Here it is. Instead of date, I'm putting the title, when would you like to have your vehicle repaired. Okay, so we have it over here, everything looks fine. Now at present it is showing only date. I want date plus time to be very specific. Okay, so I'm selecting this one, show date and time. Now we have date and time as well. Okay, now after this you can see some more advanced options, almost the same thing. Okay, when you click on this, you can select all years, or you can select okay only 2018, for example. Obviously we don't want to give past options, so I'm selecting only 2018. When they select year, they'll get only one option. Okay, or maybe 2018 to 2020. Okay, so now as you can see, they get 2018, 2019, 2020. It's all up to you. And then minimum 1 hour, maximum hour, you can select all these options. Okay, so let's first, there's another option over here to expand and collapse also. I'm collapsing everything. And let me do one thing, let me bring this message at the bottom. So I simply drag and drop it over here, and let's change it. Instead of message, let me put in comments for the mechanic. So let's open this one and let's type in comments for the mechanic. Okay, and we have our form ready. You can simply click on next. We have the same options over here. Now, as I said you earlier, I'll show you how you can create this, how you can do this thing. So if you want to redirect them to this page, to some other page after submission, what you can do, you can create a new page. So let's do that. So you can hover new and click on page, and you can create some new page like thank you page, or because they are booking a service, you can create a confirmation page. So let's create a confirmation page, and you can type in something like, okay, we have received your request, thank you for your service and blah blah blue, we'll get in touch with you very soon and this and that. Okay, so I'm just typing something, some text over here. Okay, something like this. Now we can change this style again. I'm putting it full width. Let's click on publish. Let's view this page in a new tab. Okay, so this is the page, and obviously you can add some videos, some images. You can use all these color options and so on. You can create any kind of page. You can use the Elementor to create a very beautiful page, and you can redirect them to that page after this. Okay, so it's all up to you. So let me copy this link and let's paste over here. All right, now we have this thing, Google reCAPTCHA. So it is also very easy. Just open this link in a new tab, Google reCAPTCHA thing, or you can type in google.com/reCAPTCHA. You'll be redirected to this page. Now let's click on my reCAPTCHA. Obviously I'm logged in, that's why it is showing. Now what happens is you can put in your, I have already created one for this one, as you can see, test.nayashik.com, and I have one for this, test.nayashik.com. If you want, you can add new, because obviously you will not have created this. So what you can do, you can put in your website name over here. So you can simply copy your website name. It's really easy to create it. Okay, there is nothing in this. Simply copy your website name, your domain name from here. Come to this page. Where is that gone? Here it is. And make sure you select this one. Okay, reCAPTCHA version 2. You have some more options over here, but I would recommend you to select this one. Okay, so select this thing. You can add some labels over here if you want. You can put in your website name. That would be very simple. So I'm putting test.nayashik.com. And here you have to put in the domain name. So again, I'm putting the same thing, my domain name. Then tick mark over here that I accept the reCAPTCHA terms of service. Click on register. All right. Now, once you do so, you'll see this page. Now, here you have all the keys. You have the site key. You have the secret key. Simply copy the site key. Paste it over here. First tick mark this. You'll get this option, site key. Then copy this one, secret key. Copy it from here. Paste it under secret key. Click on next. Okay, and you can design this thing. We have seen this thing. So let's click on save form. Now let's again come back to this page. Here it is. Not this one, I think. Where is that page? Okay, let's see. Let's see the form that we have created. We have created some contact us page, I guess. So let me type in contact us. This is the page. Now, as you can see, the form is already changed and you have some new options over here. So let me again put all the options. I'm putting routine service. I want this. Again, you can select these things as well. Okay, so I want this for this time and date. And my message is simple message. And I just tick mark over here. I'm not a robot. Okay, you can see everything is working fine. Just click on submit. Now, as you can see, we are redirect instead of that simple message, we are redirected to this confirmation page. So it's all up to you. You know how to do that. Okay, so this is how you use this plugin. I hope you enjoy this video. If you enjoy this video, make sure to subscribe to my channel. Also give a thumbs up to this video. That would be really appreciated. If you have any doubt, any comments, any queries, any suggestions for me, you can leave them in the comment section below. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. See you soon.